Hi, everybody. It's Linda with Stamping School. It is December 30th. We're almost into 2023, and it's almost celebration time, which is the freebie time with Stampin' Up! And the mini catalog will start January 5th, and so will celebration. One of the papers in here I had some questions about from some of you as the Dainty paper, and it's one of the freebies in the celebration. It's called Dainty Flowers. It's free with a $50 order in the U.S., so any $50 order, anything you want, and then you can choose this one. So I want to show you what it looks like up close so you can make good decisions when it's time to order. It's very pretty, and it goes with lots of things. There is a Dainty Delight bundle that we're going to be using today. I'm going to use it in this card right here, but you don't need it. This paper works for all kinds of floral things that you have, even just by itself. So let me show you what each side looks like. They always do, you know, all over pattern on one side and then the main pattern on the other. It's pretty. Lots of freesia, mellow moss, old olive, pear pizzazz, razzleberry colors. Very pretty. And this is the Starry Night, I believe, which is that pretty dark, dark purple, which is pretty. I'm going to be using that one today. All over botanical in greens with a slight seafoam background and freesia dots. This one's just gorgeous. Again, the paper's free. You get 12 sheets. They're 12 by 12. You get two of each of these designs. Two sheets, so 12 sheets total. So it's kind of a no-brainer. I think it's beautiful. This is the one you can cut right down the middle and then cut at four inches and make six really pretty card panels, which or do whatever you want with it. It's very, very pretty. And there's two sheets of that. Here's the other side, tone and tone green. And then this one, look at that. So pretty, all this watercolor splatters on the back. And this one, which we're gonna use today, I wanted to make sure that I was able to use this oval in some way because you get 12 ovals. So you can cut it right here and then cut it in fours here. And then you've got, with two sheets of these, you've got six ovals to use and then two of these right here. I'll show you what I did with that. And another splatter, which is pretty. So it looks like the same, but they are different. Those are really great for backgrounds. Now this is what the bundle looks like. This is the one you can buy. You can buy the Dainty Delight bundle. And I think there's a suite of things in there, but you could buy it if you want to go with the paper, but you really don't need it. It's pretty. It's definitely pretty, and I need to work with it a little bit more, but this one is really pretty. This pretty vine, which cuts like this, and then the stamp set, all of these cut out, these big four delicate, dainty little flowers. You can see how the die cuts these out nicely. All of these here. And then there's a bunch of little extras that you can fiddle with. It is dainty, which means, you know, little bitty things, a lot of little bitty things. So if you don't like little bitty things, maybe it's not for you. But it is pretty, and I love daisies. And you can always use like your pickup stick or something to pick up the little small pieces, but it is a lot of little bitty stuff. Definitely get the designer paper free, and then I'll show you what this card looks like and see if this stamp set bundle is for you. One thing worth mentioning is that it has greetings to it, and they have a font that we have seen before, which I love it when they do this, because if you have the Honeybee Home, it's the same font, so you can use them together, and it's the same scale, the same font, everything. So it's sort of a companion set in my mind. And here's the greetings from the Dainty Delight with the Honeybee Home. So you can use such happy news, celebrate you. You can use best of luck, the best is yet to come. You know, you're the nicest, thank you for your kindness. So they really work together well if you already have this one. Kind of expands what you can do with it. So cutting down all these oval pieces, I wanted to make a card. This is actually a belly band version. So lots of wildflowers in it. If you know someone who likes wildflowers, like I know several people who do. And I'll show you how to do this and put these little flowers together. Starting with a half a sheet of the Starry Sky cardstock, cut in half. And then you're just, to make the gatefold, you're gonna score it at 2 1/8, and then turn it around and score it at 2 1/8. And that will get you your gatefold. If you don't have something to score with, you can carefully bring it in here and use your bone folder, but it usually gets too creasy in here and it looks terrible. So you try to score it and it makes it a little bit better. So just for a nice tone-on-tone pattern, I'm doing the back side of this one. And because this is 2 inches wide, which is easy to cut, but this little panel here, remember, is 2 1/8. You might want to let the ends go just a little bit longer. So instead of 5 1/4 for the length, you might want to go to like the next little notch up because it's a skinny, skinny little border. Otherwise, you're going to want to cut this down, but that's a lot of hassle. So I just make it one little notch longer. I'll put the measurements there for you. If you expand the description, there's a link there to my PDF with the directions, so you can print that out. But it's going to be in the eighths because of the nature of a 2 1/8 inch panel. Now the inside, I think it looks nice to have a little something along the side panels. So I'm just going to put white in here for now. I can figure out what to stamp on that and then use these two. I could do those. But I'm going to add the wildflowers on the inside of each panel. So after I cut this piece down, it was about 4 by 6, I went in with my stitched rectangle and cut that out. You don't have to, you just need to trim kind of close because you don't want to take up a ton of room on here. Isn't that pretty like that? But it needs a little stability, so I made a pear pizzazz layer and a very skinny layer because the bigger layer that I had, it really took up a lot of the real estate there, and I wanted that purple to show through to match these purple flowers here. So right across the top, this is how I do a skinny layer. I'll put this darkness under here so you can see it. Only put the glue up at the top because layers are tricky anyway, but if you just go a little bit of glue at the top and then let it come down, and then you say, you know, like, do I like that? Is it good? No. Then you can still move it around a little bit. If you put glue over the whole thing, then you're in trouble. But I do just the top until I get it just where I want it to go. And it is a skinny little layer right there. And then once I like it, then I can lift this up and I can add the rest of my glue and then stick it down. That just works best for me. And we're only going to put adhesive on this side over here. So only on the far left side right here. And then get that in the center as much as you can. Give it a good rub. Okay, there's our gatefold. It's already coming together. Now we need to do the belly band. And that's why I like to do all of this inside because that does take up some space. So I want to make sure I measure it right. This is a 3/4 inch of the same Starry Sky. And it was 11 inches, but I cut it down to 10. Turn it over. No measuring here. But what you wanna do is not go too tight, so kind of press it out a little so you've got a little bit of room there. You don't want it to be so tight that they can't get it off of the card. So just a little bit right there. And there's the belly band right there. Now, the oval to go inside. I grabbed this oval from the Fabulous Frames dies, and I cut a piece of pear pizzazz and a piece of white underneath it together. This is just the basic white. It's quite thin. So I cut those together so because I wanted the green oval and the white together, and I can always use these for something else. If you have oval punches, anything would look great. It could look good this way. It'd look good this way. And then I grabbed this stamp set because I thought I really like the way that looks, and I put it on put it in some Mossy Meadow ink. That greeting is from the framed florets right here, this little guy. It fit that oval nicely. So this doesn't really, they're floating in between here just by the nature of the way this works. So I found the easiest way was to put two glue dots right here and right here in the center. And that seemed to hold that frame. And then we can glue down the inside of the frame. That works good. So that way it's a little forgiving right there, because you want that oval to be in the center of those flowers there. And just as a side note, this die right here, this one, would look really pretty on top of that, like in a gold or a green. That'd be very pretty. Of course, not with this belly band situation, but that's my next thing, is to try that. Okay, now we can just add some adhesive here and then put this right into the center. There we go. Now this little flower. Here's one of the daisies. Now I cut it out in curry out of this one. And then there are two little leaves that I did out of Mossy Meadow. And then while I was doing the daisies, I cut out these centers. It's a little die of four of them. A little cone centers. I'm missing one, but I'm going to just color, because I just ran it through the same cardstock. I could have found some of the brown, but I'm just going to color this with my darkest blend in a dark brown to make it look like the daisy. I'm trying to duplicate this daisy down here. There we go. Hold that down. See what I mean by little bitty stuff? Now this one, I'm going to color with, so I want it to look like this. It's got like this little Cajun color darkness there on that flower. So I'm taking my light Cajun craze and putting a little dot down here on each petal down toward the bottom. Then I'm coming in with my mango and kind of blending that color up. So I'm pushing that dark color, I hope you can see this, I'm just pushing it up the petal to kind of give it just a little bit of darkness there and blending it up. And if the light Mango Melody isn't enough, you can go back over it with the dark one, but this is the light. I'm using the bullet tip and just giving it a little bit of the darkness in there. If it, let it dry. If it's not dark enough for you, then you can go back and do a little bit more of that Cajun craze. Terracotta tile would work good. The light coral would work well. So it's just something kind of rust colored. And then I just want to round these little daisies up. Just, they're so delicate, but they need to not be so flat. So we're gonna curl them up just a teeny, I'm just pressing it against the barrel just to kind of lift it up. And you're gonna need a good, like the squeeze bottles that I like from Amazon to put your favorite glue in. This is the Tombow Multi in here, but you're gonna need a good glue with a teeny little tip because they're kind of little. I like, kind of think about where to put it. This one I did at the bottom, but this one I'm gonna do kind of up at the side so they're not right next to each other. This one can handle a glue dot because it's big enough. That will work, but once we get into the little bitty leaves, that's gonna take a little bit more of a tiny glue. All right, I'm gonna put this one right here. You don't want it to stick up a ton, but just a little bit. And then this little guy that we colored can go right on top here. The fine tip glue that we have is fine and it holds great, but it takes a while to dry, and when it dries, it's glossy. So for that reason, I tend to use the white glue and it just seems to stick fast. So I like that. Little bitty leaves. I'm gonna put a little bit of glue back here. Little teeny leaves go in here. Get your fingers warmed up before you try this. This die that's in the daisy set, I think that is supposed to be like this, like one of those type of flowers right here. But I cut it into that pretty new shimmer gold Cut that off. And I'm going to put that under the flower right here for a little bit of extra gold. I think that's really pretty. And then I'm going to put the other leaf over here. Pick that up and just slide that in. Slide that in. I do like that sticky end of that tool for that. I'm glad Stampin' Up! Still sells these because it's been great for these little things. And the last thing I want is a little bit of sparkle. And I wanted some of this purple sparkle, so I took my Starry Sky and just colored a few of these rhinestones with it just to give a little purple. Like one here, maybe one up here. I think that's really pretty. And they don't really get caught on here, which is nice. Whew, but that's it. That's the little bitty dainty, dainty delight. Now here's what I did with that little strip left over from that piece of paper. So that's this middle one right here. They get four of those basically. So I just thought it was a pretty bookmark. So I'm just gonna, I can put a little sentiment on here or something, and it makes just a perfect sized bookmark. A little bit of bling on there. So that's it. I hope that you get this daisy paper when Celebration comes out, because I think it is so pretty and it's going to be useful for lots and lots of different types of stamp sets that you probably already have. January 5th starts the freebies, so we'll see you then. See you next time. See it, learn it, stamp it.